rings of memory and power?
I know the story you mean, Stevie, huh? All right, I'll tell it. One day, many years ago, there was a great man loved by all who really knew him. He was on a quest, sent into the dark forest by the gods, alone, with only what he could carry on his broad, strong back. It was winter.
November.
Yes. And it began to snow. This man walked deeper and deeper into the darkening woods, until in any direction he looked, he could see no light from the edge of the forest whence he'd come. At first, he was comforted by the voices of birds and the presence of animals he could feel all around him. But as he walked on, deeper into the woods, through the accumulating snow, ducking beneath branches that seemed to swing out at him, he also walked through a silence never before imagined, as if a great cunning beast had in one long inhale sucked up all sound and spirit from the heart of the forest. He tried to sing, but no sound emerged from lips that no longer moved. Loneliness engulfed him. He could feel life flowing from his body like water from a pail. And then, looking up, I saw the tallest,
I was tall,
most massive tree I'd ever seen. And I knew at once the gods had sent me here to find you. I wielded my axe against this oldest of living beings. For 6 days and 6 nights, I cut and hacked and chopped and chopped and cut and hacked and chopped. Only by the power I felt at seeing the fruit of this destruction, a great circular wooden wall as high as any rampart around the castle. A wall of wooden shattered rings of knowledge and memory that once held you safe. And then I felt heat. And then there was a blinding flash. And covering my face with my hands, I looked through my fingers and I saw me. Yes, you, Stevie. Crying. Tears turning to steam on your cheek as you floated down to the forest floor. And around you, as numerous as the stars, like the broken fragments of you. Your former life. You would never know who you would become. You would never know who you would be. Final tear fell from your cheek and was absorbed by a single chip below, causing a chain reaction, a moaning, a groaning, and then louder, and louder, and louder, until all the former fragments of you gathered together and became the great cunning beast.
You?
Yes, me!
Then you die. Right?
story, if I die, you would be just fine. But enough of this. We will not tell the story again, Stevie. It's much too hard on you.
We could tell the story again.
I love the story.
We could do it again. I'm not tired.
I am, Stevie. And if I'm tired, then you must be too.
Who am I?
Get some sleep, Stevie. Stevie, give me your hands. What?
Who am I? Am I me? Am I you? Am I magic?
You're nobody, Steve. You're mine. I take care of you. You know I love you, don't you, Stevie? Do you love me?